Yes, guys, let's check question number 7. Butley Boy and Company carried on a manufacturing business and the products were sold to wholesalers and the company had its own retail shop as well. Adhikari Limited carried on a similar manufacturing activity, but all the goods produced were sold through the company's own retail shop. The summarized balance sheet of the two companies are given to you. Balance sheet of Butley Boy and Adhikari, both are given to us. Come down below. The original cost of plant and machinery in both the companies were 26 lakhs and 2 lakhs. The following arrangements were made and carried out on 1st April 2012. Butley Boy and Company purchased the shares of Adhikari Private Limited by issuing each share at, all the issued shares at 14 rupees per share. So 14 rupees per share is the valuation of Adhikari Limited. So Butley Boy is buying all the shares in Adhikari at 14 rupees per share. The shareholders of Adhikari Private Limited took over the freehold property of Adhikari Private Limited at 60,000 at the book value for the same. It was agreed that such amount will be set off against the amount due to them under 1 below. So under 1 is nothing but the PC. So against the purchase consideration, they are setting off 60,000 rupees of freehold property which was taken out from Adhikari Limited. And the balance due to them were to be satisfied by an appropriate number of equity shares in Butley Boy Limited issued at 19.5 rupees per share. Necessary transfer in regard to setting off the price of the property taken over by the shareholders against the amount due to them from Butley Boy Limited were made in books of both companies. Point number 3, though does not have any value, has a high significance with adjustments to point number 1 and 2. 3 is very, very important. All the manufacturing was carried on by Butley Boy Limited and all the retail business were taken over by Adhikari Limited in this connection. So there is no selling company, there is no purchasing company. Both the companies will exist, but in such a way that Adhikari Limited is only doing retail business, Butley Boy is only taking care of the manufacturing activity. So for this, what do you have to do? Butley Boy is taking over only manufacturing. So Adhikari Limited's plant and machinery will be transferred to Butley Boy. Butley Boy's freehold premises will be transferred to Adhikari Limited so that he handles only the retail business. Check what he says. Butley Boy purchased the whole of Adhikari's plant and machinery for 1,50,000. They carried on their freehold property having a cost of 1 lakh at 1,20,000. Adhikari purchased Butley Boy's freehold retail shop building, cost to Butley Boy being 75,000 at 60,000. Book value of the retail stock of 80,000 at its book value itself. Butley Boy drew a check in favor of Adhikari for the net amount due, taking into consideration all the matters mentioned above. Immediately after the transfer in shares above, Adhikari Limited declared and paid 60,000 rupees as dividend. You are required to prepare balance sheet and Butley Boy Limited and Adhikari Private Limited immediately after the completion of the above transaction. Now, slightly confusing as far as the 1, 2, 3 points are concerned. Let's try to first understand the 1, 2, 3 points. Butley Boy went and purchased all the shares which were issued by Adhikari Limited at 14 rupees per share. So when Butley Boy is purchasing from Adhikari shareholders, each share, Butley Boy has to send the purchase consideration to the shareholders of Adhikari, not to Adhikari Limited. So now check, the shareholders of Adhikari Limited took over a freehold premises from Adhikari Limited for 60,000 at the book value being the same, and it was agreed that the amount will be set off against the amount due to them under 1 above. Understand, I'll put it like this. I have shareholders of A. Let's consider this fellow as one party. Then I have A, Adhikari, and I have B, Butley Boy. Butley Boy is purchasing the shares from shareholders of A. All the shares of A were purchased by Butley Boy from the shareholders of A. Who should send the PC? PC should be given by Butley Boy to shareholders of Adhikari. Since they are giving you the shares, I am giving them PC. How am I calculating PC? It is given in the point number 1. But to discharge the PC, what is happening now? My PC is not so simple. Because a portion of PC was settled by A by transfer of some freehold property itself. is transferring some freehold property and is settling. Who should pay actually? B should pay. But who is paying? A is paying. Now how did this come into picture now? Balance shares are paid by B. No problem. Balance purchase consideration is moving from B to the shareholder. That is correct. But this can't be correct. How can this be correct? Because if it is A's property, A never had a liability to pay its shareholders. It was B's liability which was discharged by A. So though it looks so simple like this, let's make it complicated as far as the accounting purpose is concerned. Read the point number 3 very carefully. The necessary transfer in regard to setting off the price of the property over the shareholders against the amount due to them from Bartley Boy and Company were made in the books of two companies. That means, though this transaction looks very simple, A to the shareholders of A, he is saying the adjustment entry is passed in both the company books itself. Why did B come into picture? Because it is B's liability to pay its shareholders. That is the reason why B came into picture. Instead of routing this transaction like this, now let's see how I'll route the transaction. I'll route the transaction like this. As if that freehold property first came to B. A transferred that freehold property to B and B transferred that freehold property to shareholders of A in part consideration of its PC. In a part discharge of its PC, that freehold property is used by B to the shareholders of A. Now basic logic, common sense is that though there is a direct transfer, I am not taking it directly. I am saying as if that freehold property was taken over by B and then B is paying its shareholders of A. So this is the only tricky part as far as the question is concerned. Got it? So now that is the reason why he is saying I will pass the adjustment entry in the books of both books. Correct? Because A should send the freehold property to B, so A will record the transfer entry. B received the freehold property and B sent it to the shareholders of A. Two transactions as far as B is concerned. So we need to consider everything and we need to start recording the entries. First come to the PC. Let's take care of the PC now. Start with number of shares in A. How many shares are there in Adhikari? 6 lakh share capital, each share of 10 rupees, 60,000 shares. What is the value per share? I am fixing the value per share as 14. So what is the purchase consideration to acquire all the shares of A? 8,40,000. How is settling the PC? 8,40,000. I am not settling only directly out by B. First, with the freehold property indirectly transferred, less freehold property. Taken over at 60,000. PC discharged in shares of Bartley Boy is 7,80,000 then. Read. He's saying that each share in Bartley Boy Limited has been issued at 19.5 rupees per share. Point number 2. Issue price per share 19.5. So number of shares to be issued by Bartley Boy B is 40,000. So if I put up a discharge of PC, it looks something like this. Equity share capital, 40,000 into 10, 4 lakhs. Securities premium, 40,000 shares into 9.5, issued at 19.5, so 3,80,000. Don't total it here. If you total it here, the purchase consideration will only total to 7,80,000. But the actual PC is 8,40,000. Where is that 60,000? Freehold property. Freehold property. This is also discharged. This is also settled as a discharge of 60,000. Making the total PC as 8,40,000. Once you understand this logic, the solution is very simple. Because the remaining things are only arrangements. One fellow is sending the plant and machinery, other fellow is giving something else. It's just an arrangement which happens between both. If you read very carefully the point number 5 and 6, you will understand that there is a sale by A and purchase by B. In the same way, there is a sale by B and a purchase by A. Whatever B is selling, A is taking. Whatever A is selling, B is taking. So there are two transactions which are involved. So one sale by A, one purchase by A. One sale by B, one purchase by B. So let's try to understand this now. Question number 5. So let's see the net consideration, how we calculate. Point number 5 and 6. Bartley Boy purchased the whole of Adhikari's plant and machinery for 1,50,000 and a certain amount of freehold property for 1,20,000. He excluded one thing. He excluded one item here. What is that? Because Bartley Boy is purchasing plant and machinery for A of 1,50,000 and freehold property at 1,20,000 plus this freehold property also which is received by B. This is also transferred from A to B. This also should be included as far as the transfer is concerned. So the freehold property is not 1,20,000. The freehold property transferred is 1,80,000. Because that 60,000 which is directly paid to the shareholders should be first received by B, and from B we have to route it to the shareholders. So total should be 1,80,000. Adhikari is purchasing from Bartley Boy some shop buildings of 60,000 and retail stock at 80,000. So let's try to consider your net considerations. Net consideration. Put it like this first. B is purchasing from A, so B to A. A is purchasing from B, so A has to pay B. This is point number 5. This is point number 6. First column is point number 5. Let's fill up. Fill up point number 5. Fast. First one, only the consideration. The first one, plant and machinery acquired at 1,50,000. Next one, freehold property . Put a star mark here because 1,20,000 is purchased by B plus 60,000 which was transferred to the shareholders. This will become 1,80,000, not 1,20,000. 60,000 extra you have to add. Next thing from point number 6 point of view. Adhikari purchased freehold retail shop building. Guys, retail shop building, there is no particular asset, something like that. It's nothing but freehold property only. Freehold property he is purchasing at 60,000. And also he is purchasing some stock, retail stock, purchased at 80,000. Strike consideration, this is 3,30,000, 1,40,000. So my net consideration is 1,90,000 moving from B to A. That is what he said. Read that. Point number 7. Bartley Boy Limited drew a check in favor of Adhikari Limited for the net amount due, taking into account all the matters mentioned above. So 1,90,000, Bartley Boy is giving a check to Adhikari and Company. And finally, after the transfer, Adhikari Limited declared and paid dividend. Now, if Adhikari Limited declares and pays dividend, it should be received by shareholders. Who is the shareholder now? All the shares are acquired by B. So, whatever dividend A pays, B will receive. So, that entire 60,000 rupees, whatever is paid, it should be received by B again. Now, we'll park it to the balance sheet. But as of now, I have something else to be calculated now. There should be a profit or loss on sale. Compulsory. If I have a profit or loss, if I have a sale, definitely I need to calculate profit or loss on sale. Check. Point number 5. Adhikari Limited purchased whole of, Bartley Boy purchased whole of Adhikari Limited's plant and machinery for 1,50,000. Check the balance sheet. What was the book value of the plant and machinery? In Adhikari and Company, the book value of plant and machinery was after depreciation, 1,00,000. That 1,00,000, at what value is he purchasing, Bartley Boy? 1,50,000. So that leaves a profit of 50,000 to Adhikari Limited. Continue reading. Freehold property having a cost of 1,00,000 have been taken over at 1,20,000. Guys, that 60,000 what is transferred to the shareholders, there is no profit. Because 60,000 itself is the book value, no profit or loss. But here it has a profit of 20,000 again. 50,000 profit in plant and machinery, 20,000 profit in freehold building, the total profit which he made is 80,000. I'm sorry, 70,000. Come to 6th point, check profit or loss for Bartley Boy now. Adhikari purchased Bartley Boy's freehold retail shop at having a cost of 75 at 60. He is buying at less than cost. That means it leaves a loss of 15,000 to Bartley Boy and Company. He took over retail stock of 80,000 at book value. That means there is no profit or loss. So, net basis I will say, there is a 70,000 rupees of profit to Adhikari and there is a 15,000 rupees of loss to Bartley Boy. These are two things that we have to calculate. So, put on profit or loss on sale. It's given as B and then A, so I'll maintain the same order. First check B's loss, then check A's profit. To get B's loss, we need to consider point number 6. Point number 6, come on. First one, Adhikari Limited purchased Bartley Boy's freehold property. Freehold retail building is nothing but freehold property. Having a book value of 75,000 at 60, negative 15,000 is the profit or loss of 15,000. Stock 80,000 at book value leaves no profit, no loss. Fill up A's column, read point number 5. Bartley Boy purchased Adhikari Limited's plant and machinery. Whole of plant and machinery's total cost is 1,00,000 and such. Total plant and machinery was taken over as 1,50,000. Book value being 1,00,000. He has taken over at 1,50,000. Leaves a profit in A of 50,000. A certain freehold property having a cost of 1,00,000 at 1,20,000. So freehold property plus 20,000. 15,000 loss to B. 70,000 profit to A. And we are done with the problem. But the crux of the story lies in how you draft the balance sheet. Lot of adjustments involved when we are drawing the balance sheet, guys. Please be very, very careful. I need to prepare the balance sheet of both companies. Balance sheet of both A and B as on a particular date. The date mentioned above. After all transactions, I'll take it as 1/4/2012. Come on. Let me maintain two columns. One is A and B. And let's start. Balance sheet adjustments, be careful. start normally with your equity and liabilities. Go on. First one, shareholder funds. Share capital, equity share capital. Come on. Butley boy, what is already given in the balance sheet is 25 lakhs plus. Now he is issuing 4 lakhs share capital. Because I am purchasing the shares of Adhikari Limited, I am settling him by shares of 40,000. 40,000 shares, 4 lakh share capital. My total share capital of, I'm sorry guys, I'll just shift it as B and A, because B is given first then A. I'll write in the same order. My share capital will become 29 lakhs of Batley Boy. Adhikari, no change. Adhikari Limited did not issue any shares. 6 lakhs is always 6 lakhs. But the only change is all those shares were now purchased by Batley Boy and company, which will appear in the asset side of Batley Boy as investment in A. So we'll take care of that when investments come up. Now come to reserves and surplus. Come on guys, reserves and surplus, one reserve we give, that's it, P&L, only one reserve, that is sufficient to irritate us. Come on, check for B first. What is B's P&L given? I'll start with that. 3,40,000. Loss on sale? 15,000. One more adjustment which is supposed to be taken. One more adjustment supposed to be taken is the dividend, guys. Check the dividend. If Adhikari Limited is paying dividend, then obviously Batley Boy is receiving the dividend. The entire 60,000 rupees of dividend, I'll add it up here. Oh, this will make it 3,85,000. I have securities premium as well as far as Batley Boy is concerned. $3,80,000. Come to A. Open your brackets for P&L. Come on. P&L. 90,000 existing. Plus profit on sale, 70,000. One more. Dividend paid, profits will reduce by 60. The profit and loss left out in A is 1 lakh. There is no securities premium in A. No non-current liabilities. I'll directly go for current liabilities then. No change in the value of creditors. Pick up same values. 4,20,000 and 70,000. 40,85,000. 7,70,000. Balance sheet figures on the liability side is simple. Asset side, lot of pluses, lot of minuses which happen. Assets. Non-current assets. Tangible fixed assets. Under tangible fixed asset, the first one is freehold property. Careful. Very careful when we pick up freehold property, guys. Come on, guys. Let's start. Freehold property for B. What is the freehold property? Balance sheet value. Balance sheet value starting with 10 lakhs. Come on. Plus, freehold property taken over from A. So B has taken over from A a freehold property of 1,80,000 plus 180. Do not forget, they also transferred. They also gave to B. How much did they give to B? See point number 6. So this already gave to A. Bartleyboy has, Adhikari Limited purchased Bartleyboy's freehold premises shop building having a cost of 75,000 costing freehold property was transferred to A. They have purchased 1,80,000. They have sent 75,000 to A. One more. 60,000 transferred to shareholders of A for purchasing the shares in A. This is important. Very important one. Make it a total of 10 lakhs. I think this is 10 lakh 45. Check from Adhikari, come on. Adhikari is freehold property existing 250. Very good. How much did he acquire from B? Read point number 6. Freehold property, freehold building acquired at 60,000. Minus, how much did he transfer to A? Read point number 5. Freehold property having a cost of 1 lakh transferred to A. Should I stop there? Minus 60,000 transferred to shareholders directly. Even that. Or you can directly write it as 1,60,000 which is transferred to B. Get the answer now. 60-60 cancel. This should be 1,50,000. Next, plant and machinery. Come on. This is simple, guys. Plant and machinery. One simple thing I can tell is, Adhikari Limited does not have any plant and machinery left out. Because read that point number 5. Bartleyboy purchased the whole of Adhikari Limited's plant and machinery at 1,50,000. That means the entire plant and machinery is wiped out into B's books. B's, what is the plant and machinery already existing? 13 lakhs. Plus, what is he acquiring now? How much did he acquire it for? 1,50,000. So 13 lakhs plus 1,50,000 is only 14,50,000. Straightforward figure. Do not forget investment in B. Or investment in Adhikari. In the books of B. What is the purchase consideration? 8,40,000. Bartleyboy purchased all the issued shares of A for 8,40,000. Then let's come to current assets. First current asset, stock. Small adjustment is there in stock. Where is the stock adjustment? Read point number 6. Adhikari Limited purchased Bartleyboy's freehold retail shop building having a cost of 75,60 and took over retail stock of 80,000 at its book value. That means 80,000 book value has been transferred from B to A. So reduce B stock, increase A stock. 80,000. Reduce B stock 80,000? 4 lakhs. Increase A stock 80,000? 2 lakhs. Next, debtor. Debtors, no change, 2,30,000, 80,000. As it is. Do I have adjustments to bank? Yes. I have two adjustments to bank. One, is the dividend A paid to B? Two, this amount, what net consideration B transferred to A. So, one is plus 2A, minus 2A. So, let's see how it happens. Bank for Batley Boy. What is the opening bank? 2,50,000. How much did he pay to A? Minus 1,90,000 paid to A. But he also received from A 60,000 rupees. Same thing will be reverse order for A. What is A's cash? A's bank is 2,10,000. 1,90,000, whatever B paid has been received by A. And then he paid a dividend of 60,000. The balances strike. This is 1,20,000. This is 340. And the balance sheet should tally. Check balance sheet should tally, guys. At that value. Yes, be tallied. A tallied. B. Be tallied. That's it. The most irritating part in the question is this one. If you understand this, that the freehold property, though was transferred directly by A to shareholders, it was basically a routing through B because it was B's consideration to be paid. So B had to discharge the consideration, move directly to A from A. We have to pass it indirectly through B. Then you will get the answer. If that is simple understanding is understood, then your answer is straight. Let me tell you one more thing. Even if you don't consider this transaction this way, your answer will tally. But the answer is not right. Because when we fail to add 60,000 to this value here, this will be 270. This will be 130. So 130 paid from B to A, that means I'll reduce B's cash, I'll add A's cash. As simple as that. So whatever you do, ultimately it will tally. But the only thing is, you need to know how much to add, where to add. Got it? So, please be careful as far as the question is concerned. This adjustment B, please mark it so that you can have your further reference for this.